People, here we are. This is Bali. I've been here for, I don't know, kind of 4, 5, 6 days already, and I gotta say, Bali is fucking awesome. I think we're in Canggu, but I'm not sure. but Bali is awesome. In all these days, I've been able to travel a little bit around and surf, of course, and eat and drink and have fun, you know. And I have a couple of things I want to say about this. And one of those is that Bali is this contrast of the old and the new. Look. Look at all this development in the middle of the fucking rice fields. Where have you seen that? Houses with air conditioning, hot, cold water, wireless internet, and rice paddies. It's kind of like a developing country, or it is a developing country trying to catch up with the West, specifically with the Western standards, you know? I don't know if this is fair, but it is what it is, you know? It makes me appreciate more where I live and where I was born, you know? No one wanted to say that being born in Peru is better than being born here or worse. But I don't live in Peru anymore. And goddamn, Australia is the best country, man. I don't know if it's fair for us as visitors to this country to demand Western standards here. But as a developing country that need the tourism money, they try, you know, they try their best, and I think they're achieving it. No doubt about it, they're achieving it, but it's very hard. Can you imagine? Can you imagine some visitors going to Australia, some tourists are saying, this is not good enough, you have to build it better. Break your house down and build me a better one because I like to flush the toilet paper in the toilet. You know, it's like a, it's just different worlds, man, different worlds. But this is a great place, man. So much vibrance. Even though the Western culture is kind of absorbing it, I feel a bit of a shame seeing everybody stuck to their phones everywhere in the world, including here. Everybody has a smartphone. Everybody's breaking their necks, looking down to that little screen for that instant satisfaction. I don't think it's fair to say that that's like a Western problem. It's a world problem, and I don't know. It's like there's so much to do here. Why do you want to be stuck in your phone? I can't stop thinking about the greatest of all time, Anthony Bourdain. I think I saw over 100 of his episodes from all his different shows. If memory doesn't fail me, I'm pretty sure he fell in love with this land, with Indo. and I can see why. I guess is the smile on the people's faces, the simplicity in the life they live, and the honesty in the interactions besides the taxi drivers and, you know, the tourist circuit. But the street food, the warmth, not in temperature, you know, but in the heart. I know one of his wishes was to retire here, so I guess his soul eventually will land here after he pick up all his steps around the world. Might take a while. All the layovers, all the reservations he's done in different restaurants, all the confidentiality in the kitchens he's worked before. But this island is something special, you know? I know he wasn't a surfer, but I can't stop seeing him sitting on a plastic chair, eating some deep-fried fish, freshly caught, drinking a beer under a tilted umbrella. I know I'm gonna find him here eventually. When I get back here, spiritually, when I'm gone. I have promised myself to do the Anthony thing and have some street food tonight. Hopefully my wife won't get a belly, but I hope I'm tough enough to eat some freaking noodles on the street and don't let my bombs explode. I haven't traveled pretty much anywhere in comparison to all the places he's been, but I'm here today. I'm here now. And I can see his point. So the reason what I'm talking about this is, if you need help, if something is not right in your coconut, look for help. Get away from all the people that interfere with what you want, what you are. And find some help. Find some help, because doesn't matter what you have or what you don't have. Just don't do it, you know.
Fipal is coming in home to pledge it.
It's such a shame, man.
Come to my home.
I cannot understand why somebody in his position did something that, like what he did, you know? And I don't reprimand him because, to be honest, it's life. And death is part of it. So, it may be a premature death.